In this demo, I will talk about driver management for MDT 2010 Lite Touch. So, first of all, we basically have two different sets of drivers to worry about. First one, we have the drivers for the boot images, which is the WinPE version 3 drivers. We minimum need the NIC and storage, and since we are using Windows PU 3, it should be the Windows 7 version of those drivers. Then we have drivers for the operating system, operating systems that we add to MDT. But let's start by working with the drivers. What I recommend you to do is the following. In the workbench, you should create two different folders. One named WinPE 32-bit and one named WinPE 64-bit. And of course, you will go ahead and right-click and import the right driver set into the right folder. And the reason we do this is to make sure that we only get the drivers that we want inside our boot images, so they are not getting bloated by all the different drivers that we import for the operating systems. In order to make sure only these folders will be added to my boot images, I will go ahead and go to the Advanced Configuration and I create Selection Profiles. And as you can see, I have created a WinPE 32-bit selection profile. And if I go to Properties on this one, I have selected the 32-bit folder in here. And I also have a selection profile for WinPE 64-bit pointing to my WinPE 64-bit folder. And to tie this all together, the only thing I need to do on the production deployment share, I would have to go to WinPE components and I have to use that selection profile to make sure that the only drivers belonging to that profile, meaning that folder, are injected into the boot image. And the same goes for the 64-bit components. I would select my 64-bit profile to make sure that only those drivers are added. And by doing this, you are creating a perfect boot image that will always work for you when doing deployments. So back to our operating systems. There are so many ways of dealing with drivers in MDT, so I try to focus on three distinct scenarios to guide you through these different processes. Scenario number one, it's called total chaos. It's the default scenario. In this scenario, we have typically one operating system to deploy, like Windows 7. We have just a few hardware models, like 8, and they are all from the same vendor. For this scenario, I would say use the default method. It will actually work quite well. The default method is basically go into the workbench, right-click drivers, import, and just add the drivers in here. What MDT will do when you start a deployment, it will do a plug-and-play ID detection of the machine, and it will match that against the imported drivers in the repository. Now, what's the downside of this? Well, basically, if you update one driver, or add one driver, or remove one driver, you will actually have to retest all those 8 models, because you don't need to know what models you are affecting. The second scenario is called added predictability. Now we're not only deploying Windows 7, but also Windows XP. And since we now have multiple operating systems, we may have maybe 18 models, but they're still from the same vendor. But problem is now, since we are relying on plug-and-play ID detection, we want to make sure that only Windows 7 drivers are injected for Windows 7 deployments, and XP drivers are only injected for XP deployments. We still use the default method, but we add selection profiles as a filter. So in the workbench I do this. I create a folder for my Windows 7 32-bit drivers, and I create another folder for my Windows XP drivers. And then I make sure to import the Windows 7 drivers into the Windows 7 folder and the XP drivers into the XP folder. Then again, I will create selection profiles. So I will create the Windows 7 selection profile where I have my Windows 7 folder. And I have an XP profile where I have selected my Windows XP folder. To tie this into the deployment, if I go to my Windows 7 sequence, if I go to the sequence, go to the inject drivers action, I can actually select only to look for drivers belonging to the Windows 7 profile. And of course, in my Windows XP profile or in my XP sequence, I would select the Windows XP profile as well. Then we have the third scenario, where we are, the name is Total Control. And now the scenario is that we still have multiple operating systems, but we have many more models, and now we have multiple vendors. When we still had only one vendor, they test their models against the other models from the same vendor. But Lenovo will not test their models against a single repository, against all HP machines or against all Dell machines. So we need to have a more granular level of control. Now I would say that the default method cannot be used anymore. You should rather use something called driver groups. Let me demonstrate that. So in the workbench, I would rather go ahead and start creating a more complete structure. As you can see, I'm having a top level folder for the OS, then the make, and then the model. And then of course for my HP Compact 8510 for Windows 7, I add my models in here. And for my Dell D630, I will add the models or drivers in there. MDT will still be single instancing, so even if you add the same driver twice, it will only store it once, but in the UI it will appear as you have duplicates of that drive, but that's just a logical representation of the drivers. So I create a more granular structure, add the drivers, but how do I tie this into the sequence? Well, if I go to my Windows 7 sequence again, what I will do, before the action that injects drivers, I will set the driver path. I would set driver group equals this. Because make and model is one of the variables that MDT actually figures out from your machine. And as long as your name of the folders back here is matching the real name of the hardware that you have, you will have a match and they will be added. One key step to this, when you add the driver path variable like this, you need to select the nothing profile, because otherwise they will be additive. It will add the drivers from that folder but also from all the other folders. So this is something that you need to do.